The Countdown to Camp continues, brought to you by Masterclass, answering the burning questions heading into New England Patriots training camp. I'm Sierra Goodwill, here with Edmund Lazar. We're tackling N'Keal Harry today. Will he be able to make the growth and leap that everyone is expecting from him? What do you expect to see from him, and which areas do you need to see the most amount of growth where he can reach that full potential?
Well, Sierra, I think the Patriots and N'Keal Harry are both counting on nobody being able to tackle him on the field. I think that's a big part of his skill set, is that he is so great with the ball in his hands and so great after the catch that all they really need to do is get him the ball, right? And get him the ball down the field a little bit more than they did last year so that he can create and be that playmaker. I think the biggest thing for N'Keal Harry, though, it starts at the line of scrimmage. Everything always starts at the line of scrimmage for wide receivers and cornerbacks. Being able to be more sudden and more explosive in his releases, moving guys off the line of scrimmage, and then being physical with his hands to follow through and get separation quickly within his route, that's what he's been working on all offseason with the Footwork King and with his training staff down there in Houston and on the West Coast in California with Cam Newton at times as well over the last couple of weeks. That's the biggest thing for him, is getting separation at the line of scrimmage, moving the defensive back off of his spot, creating that lane for him to release down the field, and then being a little bit crisper at the top of his routes as well. It's all about route running technique for N'Keal in year two. If he can just improve within the margins. You're not asking him to go from being N'Keal Harry to Stephon Diggs, right? We know where he's not going to just completely reinvent himself as a route runner, but if he can get a little bit better at the line and at the top of his route, then we can unlock all those physical skills that he has, the after the catch skills, the rack ability, the ability to go above the defense and catch contested balls. That's really the next step for him.
I know when we learned about the Cam Newton signing and we had our first conversation, you immediately brought up that it's pretty a good signing for N'Keal Harry. How do you expect this offense to run this year with Harry getting involved? I know you think that they need to get him the ball down the field a lot more often, but what will it look like when he's running at full speed?
Well, I think a lot of Patriots fans, and me included, when they drafted him, were kind of expecting N'Keal Harry to be sort of this chess piece, this guy that they were going to move around the formation, have him line up in the slot, have him line up outside, maybe even in the backfield at times, or sort of like a pseudo tight end H-back role, so that they can use that size and that rack ability like I've been talking about. But unfortunately for the Patriots, the best course of action for them is for N'Keal to play the X on the outside, because they already have a bunch of redundancy at that slot position with Julian Edelman, with Mohamed Sanu, with Jacoby Myers. All these guys are inside guys, right? So then when you start moving N'Keal inside, you start to get a ton of overlap in route trees of, you know, where N'Keal is really good at running this route, but so is Sanu. And Sanu is really good at running that route, but so is Edelman. So you sort of get into a little bit of a traffic jam there at that position. So ideally for the Patriots, N'Keal would develop on the outside, his skill against press coverage, so that he can be that dominant X receiver for them, a la a Dez Bryant type of player, right? But if he doesn't get there, I think at the end of the day, you got to start crafting ways, if you're Josh McDaniels, just to use his ability as a ball carrier. Similarly to what we saw at times last year, where they did run schemes to get the ball in his hand, reverses, you know, sliding him out the backside into the flat, things like that, or, you know, things that maybe the Niners have done with Deebo Samuel, who's a similar type of running back playing wide receiver at times. So I think that his usage needs to be a little bit more creative, because I'm not sure that he's going to be that guy that can consistently win against press coverage on the outside, down in and down out, and be a dominant receiver in that sort of role. So the question is who can they get that can play that role so that they can move N'Keal off the line and let him move around a little bit more? Maybe it's my guy, Damari Bird. Maybe it's everybody else's guy, Jeff Thomas. Those guys end up being the X receiver on the outside, allowing N'Keal to play the Z or the flanker and allowing him to move around the formation a little bit more.
Definitely one of the more exciting storylines for the Patriots this year, to see how N'Keal Harry is able to blossom in the second season. But this segment has been brought to you by our partners at Masterclass. Get unlimited access to every Masterclass, and as a Patriots Press Pass listener, you can get 15% off their annual all-access pass. Just go to masterclass.com/CLNS. And for all of our New England Patriots content, you can find it on our website at clnsmedia.com, and all the rest of our Countdown to Camp segments are on our YouTube channel at Patriots Press Pass.